Scriptures foretold that the Anointed One, Yeshua HaMashiach, the Messiah Yeshua, came to call the people back to the truth of His Word and to follow that righteous path. Yeshua then called Jewish men to be His disciples, and after His death and resurrection, those Jewish men told the world about the Jewish Messiah. Now, after 2,000 years, Beth Goyim Messianic Congregation has that same calling of those Jewish men, telling all people, both Jew and Gentile, about the proper ancient path, teaching the Route 66 King's Highway from Genesis through to Revelation, and how you need and can get back to the proper roots of the faith and a closer walk with God. Now, let's hear the message.
So our family kept going lower and lower and lower.
Mi familia fue más bajo, más bajo, más bajo.
We were so poor.
Éramos tan pobres.
I never really want to even look at any chicken anymore.
Yo no quiero ver más pollo nunca.
We ate chicken, I tell you.
Comimos pollo.
Every single day.
Todos los días.
For like 2 years.
Por dos años.
Macaroni and cheese at 59 cents a box.
Macaroni and cheese, caja de 50.
Every now and then I start going like this, walking like a chicken. I think like feathers are going to pop out of my arm. Because we were so poor. This is all we were eating. Even hot dogs were too expensive. So God was taking us down this road. Because my father would not yield to the king.
Porque mi padre no cedía al rey.
And he took everything away from him.
Y él le comenzó a quitar todo.
And even made him sick.
También lo enfermó.
When he had his heart attack.
Cuando tuvo su paro cardíaco.
And half of his face started to droop down.
Mitad de su cara se comenzó a entiesar.
But he refused to yield to God.
Pero él no quería ceder a Dios.
And his life got worse and worse.
Su vida se hizo peor y peor.
Now sometimes when you hit that bottom.
A veces cuando caes así debajo.
Some people turn to God.
Algunos vuelven a Dios.
And some people curse God.
Algunos maldicen a Dios.
And they get angry at God.
Se enojan con Dios.
Well, I've been doing things right.
Yo he estado haciendo las cosas.
Why are you cursing me?
¿Por qué me maldices?
Anybody ever been in that road?
Algunos han
getting mad at God?
Que se enojan con Dios.
I've been mad at God before.
Yo he estado enojado con Dios antes.
And then you hear the Lord's voice.
Después escucha la voz de Dios.
You talking to me?
¿Estás hablando a mí?
No, not really. Because you got to fear God.
Tienes que temer a Dios.
Because He will take you down that road.
Porque él te llevará por ese camino.
Because He cares about you.
Porque él cuida de ti.
Because when you leave this life.
Porque cuando te vas de esta vida.
The next life is a lot better. In heaven. You're not going to be reincarnated.
No vas a ser reencarnado.
When you get to see God.
Cuando llegas a ver a Dios.
You want this meeting to be good.
Tú quieres que esta junta sea.
Not a bad meeting.
No una junta mala.
So when you begin this journey.
Cuando comienzas esta jornada.
Sometimes God puts you in this pressure cooker.
El Señor te pone en esta cocinador.
And the more pressure there is.
Entre más presión hay.
The better off that diamond is going to be.
Entre más mejor va a ser ese diamante.
Because you don't make diamonds without pressure.
No puedes hacer diamantes sin
presión. And the more pressure you put on that diamond,
entre más presión le pones a ese diamante,
the better that diamond's gonna be.
Lo mejor va a ser ese diamante.
So is God putting you under some pressure?
Dios te está poniendo bajo presión.
Yes. Amen.
Amen.
Let's look now at verse 8 through 11 again.
Miren el verso del 8 al 11.
Remember, please, the word you gave through your servant Moshe. If you break faith, I will scatter you among the peoples. But if you return to me, observe my mitzvot and obey them, then even if your scattered ones are in the most distant part of heaven, nevertheless I will collect them from there and bring them to the place I have chosen to bear my name. for bearing my name. Now these are your servants, your people whom you have redeemed by your great power and strong hand. Adonai, please let your ear now be attentive to the prayer of your servant and to the prayer of your servants who take joy in fearing your name. Please let your servant succeed today and win this man's compassion, for I was the king's personal attendant. Amen?
Amen.
Returning to the biblical faith
regresar a la fe bíblica
is very difficult in normal circumstances.
Es muy difícil en sentidos algunas circunstancias.
Especially living in our pagan society today.
Especialmente vivir en nuestra sociedad pagana que vivimos hoy.
I mean, you can't even drive down the streets.
No puedes ni manejar por la calle.
You got all those advertisements on the buses.
Tienes todos esos avisos en los autobuses.
You know, all the alcohol advertisements.
Los anuncios acerca del alcohol.
You're at the supermarket and you got all those magazines.
Vas al super y están todas esas revistas.
But is it that much different than the time of Nehemiah, Nehemiah?
No será tan mal, será diferente como el tiempo de Nehemiah.
He was living in a society.
Él estaba viviendo una sociedad.
That was not fearing God.
Que no temía a Dios.
Nehemiah had a good job.
Nehemiah tenía buen trabajo.
He had a good place to live.
Tenía un buen lugar para vivir.
He was the king's cupbearer.
Era el copero del rey.
So you're standing right next to the king.
Estás parado al lado del rey.
You get to hear things.
Comienza a escuchar.
You get to know things.
Comienzas a saber cosas.
You're eating good. See, the cupbearer used to taste the wine before giving it to the king.
El copero probaba el vino antes de dárselo al rey.
So you ought to be a trusted servant of the king.
Tiene que ser un siervo confiable del rey.
So let's just say Nehemiah had a lot to lose.
Digamos que Nehemiah tenía mucho que perder.
By going to the king.
Por yendo a donde el rey.
And say, I want to go back to Jerusalem.
Diciéndole al rey, quiero regresar a Jerusalén.
I want to rebuild the walls.
Quiero reconstruir las paredes.
The king could have said, off with his head.
El rey pudo haber dicho, córtenle
la cabeza.
I
don't want this Jew next to me.
Yo no quiero este judío al lado mío.
Rebuilding these walls.
Reconstruyendo estos muros.
Imagine the pressure on Nehemiah.
Recuerda, imagínate la presión de Nehemiah.
When he heard the report about the walls.
Cuando escuchó el reporte de los muros.
And then he's feeling torn inside.
Y él se está sintiendo deshecho por dentro.
Because this place that he wanted to rebuild.
Este es el lugar que él quería reconstruir.
Was supposed to be a place of special worship.
Tenía que ser un lugar de oración especial.
Yeah, but there was no safety there.
Pero no había seguridad ahí.
The gates were broken. The walls had been torn down.
Las paredes se cayeron, las portones se deshicieron.
But there was a heart in Nehemiah.
Pero había un corazón dentro de Nehemías.
A heart to rebuild this special place.
Un corazón para reconstruir este lugar especial.
For people he didn't even know.
Para gente que él ni conocía.
He wanted to rebuild the walls of Jerusalem.
Quería construir los muros de Jerusalén.
For people he never met.
Para personas que él nunca conoció.
He wanted to build this special place back for God.
Él quería construir este lugar para Dios.
In this past week,
esta semana que ha pasado,
I was praying this same prayer.
Yo estaba orando la misma oración.
For 4 months,
por cuatro meses,
BGMC has not been in our space down the hall.
BGMC no ha estado en nuestro espacio allá donde está allá abajo.
But I knew in my heart of hearts.
Pero sabía en mi corazón de corazón.
That is supposed to be our home.
Que esa tiene que ser nuestra casa.
So as this day came closer,
mientras este día se acercaba,
for our hearing with the town,
con nuestra el hearing con el town,
the Lord spoke to me through His word.
El Señor me habló por su palabra.
As I was in my morning devotional,
mientras estaba en mi devocional de la mañana,
I walk with listening to the Bible.
Yo camino escuchando la Biblia.
And I finished the book of Ezra.
Terminé el libro de Ezra.
And I had it on my heart to restart the New Testament.
Y tenía mi corazón de recomenzar el Nuevo Testamento.
New Testament.
Nuevo Testamento.
But I didn't hit the button quick enough.
Pero no pullé el botón rápidamente.
And the book of Nehemiah started.
Y el libro de Nehemías comenzó.
So the Spirit said, listen.
El Espíritu me dijo, escucha.
And it became the battle cry
y comenzó el clamor de batalla
for this congregation.
Para esta congregación.
Hearing that first chapter
escuchando ese primer capítulo
of the book of Nehemiah,
del libro de Nehemías,
and I said to Yeshua,
yo le dije a Yeshua,
you have to remember your promises, Lord.
Tienes que recordar tus promesas, Dios.
That you called me to do this work.
Que me llamaste para hacer este trabajo.
And I was reminding him
y yo le estaba recordando
that I know the time of the Gentiles is over.
Que el tiempo de los gentiles ha acabado.
It is time for the Jewish, the Messianic believers
es tiempo para los creyentes mesiánicos
to take back their headship.
De llevar su liderazgo.
And I was reminding him
yo le estaba recordando
of all the negative comments that have come against this congregation.
De los comentarios negativos contra esta congregación.
And how the pressure was building.
Y cómo la presión estaba creciendo.
And it was building and building in my life.
Creciendo y creciendo en mi vida.
And as this hearing got closer,
mientras hearing se acercaba,
I saw this as a time where the road was going to part.
Era el tiempo cuando el camino se iba a dividir.
The Lord was either going to vindicate this ministry,
o el Señor iba a vindicar este ministerio,
or he was going to destroy it.
O lo iba a destruir.
So I asked everybody,
yo le pedí a todos,
those who were willing to pray and fast,
aquellos que estaban dispuestos a ayunar y orar,
that they would follow this Nehemiah prayer,
que iban a seguir esta oración de Nehemiah,
of seeking the Lord,
de buscar al Señor,
asking him to forgive anything that we've done against him.
Pedir perdón por cualquier cosa que hemos hecho contra él.
So Thursday night came.
Entonces vino jueves en la noche.
We were down here early.
Estábamos aquí temprano.
And the attorney was supposed to be here at 6:45 at night.
Y el abogado tenía que estar aquí a las 6:45 de la
noche.
So
we got this whole room set up.
Teníamos este room ya arreglado.
And we got all the technology set up.
Y toda la tecnología.
And we go to start the internet part of the prayer.
Cuando íbamos a comenzar la oración del internet.
And the one laptop goes down.
Y la computadora se apaga.
I said, "You're not gonna win, Satan."
Yo dije, "No vas a ganar, Satan."
Forget that part of the internet.
Olvida esa parte del internet.
So I'm looking at my watch.
Yo estoy mirando mi reloj.
I'm like, where is this guy?
¿A dónde está este hombre?
I hate when people are late.
A mí no me gusta cuando la gente
tardiness
me
just, oh, it burns me up.
La tardanza me cae mal. No me
so
gusta.
7 o'clock goes on.
Llegó las 7 de la noche.
We sound the shofar.
Sonamos el shofar.
7:05 starts.
En las 7:05 minutos.
He finally comes in.
Y por fin entra.
He goes, this place was so hard to find.
Este sitio era muy difícil encontrar.
So I take him quickly back to our space.
Lo llevé rápidamente a nuestro espacio.
Now it's 7:15.
Ahora ya son las 7:15.
And we know parking in this town,
a parquear en esta vecindad,
especially in the main part of town,
específicamente la parte media,
is horrible.
Es horrible.
So we're driving over there.
Estamos manejando para allá.
In 7:15.
En las 7:15.
And I know the thing is supposed to start at 7:30.
Yo sabía que la cosa iba a comenzar a las 7:30.
So we turn the corner by the courthouse.
Fuimos en la esquina a la corte.
And I find not one parking spot.
No veo ningún parqueo.
I find two parking spots.
Encontré dos.
Hey, what's holy glory at the old? Oh, praise you, God.
Gloria a Dios.
And I get there.
Yo llegué ahí.
And we go into the chamber.
Entramos a la habitación.
And I'm expecting a whole bunch of people.
Y estoy esperando mucha gente.
And the only people that are sitting in there.
Y la única gente que estaban ahí adentro.
Is the Spanish church people.
Era la gente de la iglesia hispana.
No people from the town.
Nadie del town.
It's like, well, this is a good sign.
Esto es buena señal.
And the board comes in.
Y después vino la junta.
And still there's nobody from the town.
Y aún no había nadie del town.
So the guy calls the proceeding to order.
La persona vino a hacerle a orden.
And he
orden.
Says, could you please stand and do the Pledge of Allegiance?
Dijo, párense para hacer el Pledge of Allegiance.
And then we get to the part, one nation under God! We wanted to make sure that was loud enough.
Yo quería que eso se escuchara bien.
And then